Today I'm here with Professor Hugh Morris of the University College London, who's a specialist in the genetics of Parkinson's. Can PD be inherited? Can I pass Parkinson's on to my children?
So usually Parkinson's doesn't run in families. So the risk in the general population for people with Parkinson's, their relatives, is slightly above average. It's about 1.7 times the background risk. Occasionally we come across families where lots of people have been affected. Mm-hmm. And some of those families we've pinpointed a spelling mistake in a gene that could relate to that. So obviously if there's a family where lots of people have been affected, we think there is an increased risk to the first degree relatives, so brothers and sisters and children. But generally for Parkinson's, most forms of Parkinson's don't run in families.
So if I have Parkinson's, should I worry about my children potentially getting it? Should I get myself tested, for example?
So the average age of getting Parkinson's is 68. So that's the average age of developing it. If you develop Parkinson's in your 20s or 30s, that's obviously quite an unusual thing to happen. And we do know there's a sort of increased risk of picking up a spelling mistake in a gene that could relate to Parkinson's people of those age groups. So generally in the UK, people are offered genetic testing if they fall into one of those groups, if they have a family history of their early onset. Things are changing a bit in that, particularly in the US and increasingly in the UK, people can send off saliva to have kind of testing done as what we call direct to consumer, so people can arrange that themselves. But generally within the NHS, it's particular groups of people with Parkinson's who would arrange genetic testing for if they wanted to have genetic testing done.
Because there's a small number of known genetic variants, aren't there, that increase your risk of getting Parkinson's. That doesn't necessarily mean you're guaranteed to get Parkinson's, does it? It just increases the risk.
We kind of divide it into two groups of genetic changes. So some are what we call like major genes, or sometimes called Mendelian genes, because they're spelling mistakes or alterations in genes that run in families, and they're kind of reproducibly passed from generation to generation. So the first gene that was identified like that was alpha-synuclein. So we know that either spelling mistakes in the alpha-synuclein gene, or actually having an extra copy of the alpha-synuclein gene, can cause Parkinson's if you live long enough to develop symptoms, and that can be passed down from generation to generation with a one in two risk of developing the disease. So that's a major gene. We also know that there are lots of genetic risk factors that slightly increase your risk of developing Parkinson's. So those are what we call common variants. So there are about 90 of those that are known now that slightly increase your risk of developing Parkinson's. So lots of people in the general population carry these variants and don't have Parkinson's. From a research perspective, both types of variants give us information about the biology of what's happening with nerve cells, and obviously understanding how this starts and hopefully giving us some clues about developing new treatments in the future. So it's kind of it may be useful from a personal point of view to understand about genetic risk, but from a research perspective, we're really interested in kind of mechanisms and how we can use this to develop new treatment in the future.
So if we take a couple of examples, LRRK2,
LRRK2. Yeah, the LRRK2 is the commonest gene that we identify at the moment that's related to familial Parkinson's. So it actually occurs in about 1% of everybody in the UK with Parkinson's carries a spelling mistake in this gene. If you have a family history of Parkinson's, about 5% of people with a family history of Parkinson's carry a spelling mistake in this gene. One of the interesting things about this gene in particular is that it varies quite a bit around the world. So actually in Ashkenazi Jewish people and in people from North Africa, it's actually much more common. So it actually occurs in between 20 and 40% of people with a family history of Parkinson's. So there's quite a big regional variation, and that particular gene variant is quite common in the UK, but it's also particularly common in populations with high Jewish ancestry or in populations with North African ancestry. It may also be, and what we think is probably the case, is there are genes we haven't discovered yet. So there are probably some new genes, if you like, that cause Parkinson's that we haven't discovered yet. And that's quite a big focus of our research here at UCL and kind of globally, is to try to make contact with people with family history, look for things we know about, but also try to discover new genes. From a person without a family history who's developed Parkinson's, say in their 60s or 70s, generally, at the moment in the UK, we are not arranging NHS testing for patients in that group. It is possible to volunteer for testing to see if you carry a variant that might be relevant for for a future drug trial. So there's a study that's been run by my colleague Professor Tony Shapira at the Royal Free called PD Frontline, where you can volunteer and send off a saliva sample, no matter what your family history or age of onset, to see if you carry genetic variants that might be relevant to the development of Parkinson's and potentially relevant for, you know, entry into a drug trial in the future that might be directed towards that variant. So those are the two sort of routes. And the project we're running actually for family, people with family history, early onset, is called Parkinson's Families Project. So we've recruited at the moment about 1,500 people in the UK with Parkinson's who either have a family history or early onset or both. And we're continuing to recruit people, and we hope that we're going to kind of make some steps forward in terms of understanding the genetics of Parkinson's based on that.
So is it your view that there's probably quite a lot to be discovered still about genetics, a lot of variants that we don't know yet?
Yes, I think there is. I mean, I think that I think based on what we know at the moment, it's possible that the sort of major genes to be identified in families, they may be quite rare, either there may be relatively few families that carry those variants. In fact, we've just identified a new gene for Parkinson's, which was published just after Christmas, and it's going through peer review at the moment. It's available on open access, open access journals. It's called RAB32. So, colleagues led by Emil Gustafsson and Matt Farrer, identified families with this genetic variation, actually originating in North Africa. Actually, we've identified some families in the UK that carry this variant as well in this gene called RAB32.
So finally, I guess you've touched on this already, but what's the future for genetic research? I guess it's partly about understanding the underlying mechanisms that drive Parkinson's.
Yeah, well, there's I think that there's the family side of things. So we're continuing to work on families' early onset cases. The genetic technology is changing all the time, so it's now possible to look at long stretches of DNA that might carry expanded regions or extra copies or removed copies, so we can do much more sophisticated analysis that might explain some of the missing genetics. I think one of the important things is moving into different populations and understanding more about the genetic basis of disease in other populations. One of the things that happens in different populations, different parts of the world, is that their background genetic variation is different to people of European ancestry. So Europeans, South Asians, East Asians, people in Latin America have a different background variation. So the Global Parkinson's Disease, Global Parkinson's Genetics Program completed about 6 months ago the first large study that was done in African ancestry individuals. So this included individuals in Nigeria and African American individuals analyzed together. Mm-hmm. And in fact, the genetic profile of Parkinson's in African ancestry individuals is completely different to the profile in European individuals. So if you look at the sort of spread of the map of variation across the genome, the risk areas for Parkinson's in African individuals, African ancestry individuals versus European, it looks completely different. I think this is a really important step forward. So.